It's a good thing that Star Trek Discovery is set to take place before the original series. At least it can be. I know some Star Trek fans who are pretty upset about this revelation, particularly because Star Trek is all about strange new worlds, pushing the frontier, going where no one has gone before. And if it's a prequel, that means the frontier in Discovery is well within the frontier in Star Trek works that happened later in the timeline. And I'm not going to argue that point, because there is merit to it. But that's not to say that Discovery can't take our story in a direction that hasn't been explored in other Star Treks. It's a big, big galaxy, and we've only ever seen a very small fraction of it, told from the perspective of one ship at a time. So all hope isn't lost in that regard. My point comes up when we consider the alternative to a prequel, which is, of course, a sequel. Something that happens after Star Trek Voyager, or technically after Nemesis. But I do have a few problems with the idea that Star Trek should continually take place further and further in the future. The first problem is that the TNG DS9 Voyager era of Star Trek actually offers very few new frontiers. It's the most heavily explored era of Star Trek. The vast majority of alien races, planets, ships, historical events, and almost everything we know of as Star Trek happens in this era. So, what could we expect from a post-Nemesis series? Honestly, it's a very small galaxy in this era, very interconnected. And if we want to tell a story here, it has to either be a Star Trek series that's pretty much just about Star Trek, and consequently gives us very little in terms of pushing the frontier, or a Star Trek series that has a very similar premise as Voyager. In that case, exploring an unexplored era of established Trek history would be preferable. That's either pre-original series or between the original series and the Next Generation. The second problem is that Star Trek is not about the future. It's about us, here and now. The original series did not depict a perfect utopian world with evolved humans with no money and no needs and no conflict. It depicted humanity much how humanity found itself in the 1960s. Imperfect, but with a mind for change and a wonder of the unknown. The feeling that anything was possible. And the cooperation of a multiracial crew was not something that was possible only in some ideal future. It represented what could be here and now if we just got over our prejudices. Not sometime in the future after we've grown up a bit, the way that the Next Generation and onward approach social change. Star Trek now, more than ever, needs to be about us. Not about the politics of a government and alien races that don't even exist. And what better time period to bring us back into the universe than about the time of the original series? A time period that's mostly unexplored, despite being a prequel. We don't know much about the wider scope of the political environment in that time period. We don't know what new exciting discoveries lie waiting in a time period that's mostly forgotten by Captain Picard's time. Discovery needs only to tweak the look of the show, because honestly, in many ways, despite the aesthetics, the original series feels more authentically futuristic than other Star Treks, because it relied on not showing much technology. The original series was almost entirely devoid of the technobabble that characterized much of the feel of the Next Generation and onward. A lot of the technology of the original series era could easily be reimagined into pretty authentically futuristic territory without breaking the fundamental feel of the universe. And most importantly, we'd be dealing with a time period that wouldn't be so far in the future that we could easily shrug off its social progress as something only a future society could achieve. But that's just my somewhat off-the-cuff reaction to this news. I'd love to hear what you have to think about this topic. Is there a way that a post-Nemesis Star Trek could be new, authentically futuristic, socially relevant, and still feel like Star Trek? Well, that's it for now. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like it and comment telling me how you feel about it, how I could improve, how I'm wrong, all that good stuff. And don't forget to subscribe. I'm releasing new videos every Tuesday and Friday. See you then.